Good morning, my lovely Pisces, Pisciano. What's popping? I hope that everybody has woke up feeling better than they did yesterday. And I hope everything will go out your way. If you feel like you're going through something, I hope that today is a better day for you. All right. Thank you for all those who like and share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for all those who donate and get private readings. And thank you for all those who go onto my web and purchase my Black Magic Spell Breaker candle. This candle is if you think anybody is doing black magic on you, or they talking negative about you or wishing bad on you, or you know how people just jealous and envy, okay? This is the health and wealth and abundance candle. And this is the love yourself candle, but if you go onto my web, it is the pink one, not the red one. All right, that is the love candle if you go onto the web. All right, this is the best thing that you can use to break anything off of you. It's the walnut bath. I also have that in salt, and I also have that in herb baths. You can also use this here. I got all kinds of things going on. I made bracelets, and these are the bracelets that I make right here. I have all kinds of bracelets. That's the one I have on. All right. I sell these bracelets. I sell sage with Palo Santo. All right. I sell all kinds of stones, all kinds of energy breaking protection. If you go in there, you will see it. My oils come like this, and you can get these also if you want them in the dry, and I don't know where it fell at. But if you want them in a dry form, they come like this. This is the tranquility, but it comes in everything that I have, wet to dry, in case you need to put them in your dry products. I don't know what you need to put them on, okay? What else? Okay. So, I always put my protection sign on my hand, and this is for anybody that wish evilness on me. The evil eye, believe me, left and right, third eye, both my eyes, my crown, my chakras and all. Back to you, whatever you want to do or think, or why you watch me, if it ain't for the good. Back to you, boo-boo. Back to you, voodoo, hoodoo, poo-doo. Back to you. And I always ask for protection for my Pisces. I'm going to ring the three bells three times, and we'll start the reading. All right, there it is. Let's get started with your reading, and let's see what they want you to know. All right, oops. Let's see what I'm going to start off with. All these cards. Cards everywhere. All right, Pisces. I ask Archmichael Jonah Arc to come join me, and I ask him to protect me as I do your reading. Take my energy out of your reading, okay? Let it be about you, all right? Do not let my energy involve in this reading. I ask Jonah Arc, Archmichael, to take my energy away from this. Let me see everything I need to see in the cards so that you can get a good reading or be clear about what you need to know. All right now, so here we go. All right, let's see. The first card is coming out. Archangel Triple Art, please give me a reading. Stuck in the mud. So I don't know if somebody's feeling stuck in the situation. Maybe you got news that you didn't want to get. You don't know how to make up your mind. this can be anything. Feeling vulnerable about something, feeling that you can't make up your mind, feeling that the mind is already made. Now it's the process of moving forward. Tell me more. Tell me more. Solitution. Not only are you stuck, or somebody stuck in making a decision or moving forward, but someone is in solitution. And if you can see, you can see the shadow looking at the foundation, okay? And it's in the middle of nowhere. Solitution, all right? Maybe the 21 is a good number, or 13, but solid, stuck and being in solitution is giving you time to think about what I need to do next, all right? Do not dwell on whatever it is that you're going through and keep talking about it, because the more you talk about it, the more energy you're spreading about that energy that's not good up in the air. Leave that alone and try. And I'm not saying it's easy for you to move on from a situation, but try every day. Stop over and over and over and over and over and over talking about it. It ain't going to help the situation. You know, let's move on. Look at this movement. And I just said it and it came out. So now, it's funny how, you know, you got this bird that's saying, I'm not stuck and I'm pretty big. It's like you are in this air balloon and you seen everything small, all right? What was once so gigantic to you, it's going to become smaller and smaller and smaller. I see a lot of clouds, which still means that you're in your head about a situation that you need to move forward on. Okay, this is carrying it all on his back, all right? Everything is on his back, but it's moving forward. It's moving. It's not going to stay where it's at. It's letting you know that, you know, you may feel, or they may feel stuck, or somebody is feeling stuck. They're going into solitude where they're going to have time to think about everything. And they're going to move forward because you have to move forward. Ain't nothing in the world that's going to keep you stuck. You're not going to spend the rest of your life being stuck on a situation. It's time to move forward. You know, it's time to stop depending on someone else to make your life happier or to make you feel happy. It's time for you to find your own happiness. You know, sometimes we give a person the right to make us happy, and I think that is like the most dumbest thing for somebody to do, is to put your life in somebody's hand and say, here, I give you control over my life, all right? But when things don't turn out right, now you feel like you are being left back, or somebody here feels like something has moved on. And I said on that Mercury, that full moon that just passed, there was a lot of craziness going on. I mean, craziness. All right. But like I said, somebody here is stuck in a situation, solitution, and need to move on from a situation. Embodiment. Now, sworn from the flesh, okay? The most alliance, liberty, still my pain as the sky bleeds for my heart and the embodiment I am to claim. So somebody here is really going through something that made them make a decision to move forward, and maybe you wasn't ready, or they wasn't ready, or somebody here, you know, ain't ready to move forward, or wasn't ready to move forward when all of this came down, or maybe it's something you didn't want to hear, but you knew it all along, but now that you heard it, you know, you might have not liked what you heard, but you knew all along, you knew it all along. So now it's time that you're saying, even though it hurts me, I know I got to get out of this sticky situation because it's not going to be good for me. It says, break free, dear one. Spread wide and far from and far for your, you aren't contemptible. Okay? You are limitless. Okay? Nobody can make you stay where you at. When somebody say you need to move on, or somebody wants to, you in solitude and it's time for you to start moving around. Start doing stuff. Get out of a situation that is not serving you, or somebody here is leaving somebody behind that they've been in a situation they don't want to be in. All right? Either they're leaving you behind or you leaving them behind. All right? But whoever was in the situation, it was real painful. Either they had you in a situation where you got your feelings involved, and now this person is telling you, you know, this is the truth. Now, it's up to you whether you want to sit there and allow the bullshit or you want to move forward. But if somebody here is feeling some type of way, all right, and they don't like the way they feel, but they need to spread their wings and fly free, all right? Everything in this picture is dark. It's nothing here light. But your wings to fly free. First of all, the horse ain't the one that got the wings. You can see all of this horse skeleton, all of it, all right? It's almost like a ghost, right? It is a ghost. And the only thing that is not a skeleton, that is not a skeleton, is you, because you got the wings to free yourself, break free from a situation that got you feeling in solitude. Now, I'm going to say it again. The horse, you can see the whole skeleton. It's like almost like you are being in solitude and you need to free yourself from whatever it is that has been. It's like you, it's like a person that you meet or you've been with. And that person is full of a lot of shit that's going on in their life. But you know, you already knew what was going on. But now, you feel like you gotta, it's like you, now you're back into what you was before. Feeling like in and out of your situation that it's not going to serve you. If shit ain't right and somebody got too much shit with them, I don't know why would you want to even be in a situation that somebody has a lot of luggage to carry. A lot of luggage. And you just one more luggage on their back. And then you and find yourself coming in and out of situation that is not serving you. And it's going to be nothing but heartaches and pains and headaches. Right? Tell me about this movement. And it's telling you to move on. But it seems like you just keep looking at what you're comfortable with. Or what you see that you feed in your eyes. And I'm saying it again, some people get themselves in situations they in. I'm going to say it like this. I'm going to say it like this. Say, like the person that I was with for all these years. Just, okay, I'm not even going to say that. Say you know of somebody. And that person, you think they got money or they flashy and they got this and that. So that attracts you because your lifestyle in the past was fast. Maybe you was addicted to drugs, all right, or addicted to the street life, all right? And all of a sudden, one time came, you started, you cleaned yourself, and now you're working, you're doing this and that, all right? Then you are attracted to that fast life. And the minute somebody, you think somebody got money or something like that, that attracts you. That makes you feel good. And so you chase something that's not for you. Because that's your lifestyle. And I'm going to say something to everybody. it ain't one person in the world that is not addicted to some type of shit. Everybody has some type of addiction, all right? Everybody, whether you're addicted to drugs, sex, lying, cheating, okay, gambling, all right, eating, sleeping, working, loving somebody till you can't love them no more, okay? The street life, you know, it's always an addiction. And we all have it. I don't give a fuck. Too much drinking. All right? We all have an addiction. Every one of us in the world. All right? But you are attracted to who you are. And that's all I'm going to say. If you're going to cleanse yourself and you out there saying, I'm not going to do no more drugs. I'm not going to be seeing all these people that dog me. But if that's what you're attracted, you got to fight the monkey in you. On your back every day and say, no, I'm not going back to that. No, I'm not going back to seeing somebody else's man. No, I'm not going to be in a third party. No, I'm not going back to my baby's father that keeps cheating on me. No, I'm not going to be with somebody that keeps giving me money just to keep me in a place where it's not good for me and I'm not growing. It's a lot of shit here that you need to face. And then you live a life and you and some people are so damn controlling. But here shows that you stuck in a situation and you can free yourself and move yourself, but you're doing a lot of thinking about this. A lot of thinking. You or the person, whoever I'm talking to, fit it where it fits. You can reverse the roles, but fit it where it fits. All right? So tell me what I need to know. Tell me about this movement. You know, it's like, you know, we all are used to giving everything to a person. And what we do, and we crippling people. Or, because in the long run, I don't give a fuck what nobody got. Just because they can have $1 billion and not give you shit. But you chasing somebody for the wrong reasons. It's like you feeding your eyes. And then not your soul. Because once you feed your soul, you're too far in to even get out. Some of y'all meet people that in the wrong places. Y'all meet people in the wrong places. In fucking the wrongest place in the world. They're either in a halfway house, getting out of jail, fucking NAAA, you know, being just leaving their baby mama, leaving their baby father, getting a divorce. Y'all meet these people in a wrong motherfucking place in your life. Like, but and because that's what you used to. You understand? People that hurt people meet hurt people. All right? And that's some real shit. All right? But that's what you're doing. Now, for this movement, it says go. It says go. It says, I'm flawless, I am in the path I choose for. I've never been led astray away from my way. So somebody here is coming to a third eye. Somebody here knows. And let me tell you, ghosts can climb the highest mountain and be in a place on mountains that you can break your neck if any other even animal try to climb it, they hurt themselves. But they're good climbers and they go as high as they can go. So somebody is moving away and your third eye is moving on for you to, you know, for you to find, it's like you always seem to find your own way. But you got to go through all this shit just to find your way. That means you're going to be abused all for everywhere you're going. You know why? Because you allowing this shit to come to you. You allowing the bullshit to happen to you. Okay? And it seems like you don't know how to get out of bullshit because you like bullshit. All right? You like people that feed you lies. You like people that mistreat you. You like people that use you. It's like you are addicted to pain and hurt. And abuse, okay? And Some of us will stay in this addiction for a long time. And it's going to, I don't know, what's it going to take for a lot of us to wake up and see that shit ain't right. If shit ain't right, shit ain't right. But some of us want to make it where you want to make yourself part of somebody. And this person can tell you all the negative shit that's going in their life. But you want that. It's like you can read a person, but this is what you want. And it's like because you don't want nothing better for yourself. You used to being trashed. And I'm not, I feel this way. I'd rather be happy than trash. And I don't care if I got to fight myself not to go back to where I was. It's a fight. It's a struggle every day I go through. But it's worth it because I'm fighting for me. I'm not going to let nobody abuse me. So I feel like somebody here is used to it and they like that nasty, fucked up ass life. All right? They like to be, it's like you live in chaos. Your life is chaotic. All right? No matter how much you try to live your life right, you full of in chaos because that's what you're drawn to. It's like you're looking for a high that you already had, and it's like you'll never reach that high again. And it's in a worse way in your life, but that's what you're reaching, a fucked up ass high. Some people smoke weed till they can't smoke no more. They will smoke 4 or 5 blunts a day. How much fucking high can you get? It's like you're wasting your shit. It's like drinking. You're going to drink till you pass out. You're going to drink till you got to throw up. You're going to drink till you fucking get nasty and start acting crazy with people. It's nasty. It's just a fucked up ass situation to be in. But that's what you used to. You used to being abused. And you looking for the abusement. Oh, it gets you a high. Alright? It says happiness. You think, oh, your thinking will either make you happier, happiness, or take your happiness. You choose. Your thinking either is going to make your happiness or take your happiness. You choose. And this is what I've been saying. What the fuck are you choosing? Because you ain't going to have it both ways. You playing with the devil. You're not playing with God. You playing with the devil. Because the only person here that you're lying to is your fucking self. All right? And that's some real shit. I don't know what kind of bad boys y'all like or bad girls, but y'all get ready to get them. Because y'all look like y'all can't move away from them. It's like you feed your eyes, not your soul. You looking for that bad boy look, somebody look good, and got the inside of them as stanky as hell. You look for somebody that, oh, I like them because this and that. You are attracted to you size people from the outside. You don't know shit about this motherfucker. But you want what they look like or what you think they got and they ain't got shit. Baby, please. Energy. Stop trying to please everyone. Everyone is a whole lot of people. Protect your energy. And this is what I've been talking to you all freaking morning. Speak up. If you avoid conflict to keep the peace, you start a war inside of yourself. That means if you're trying to keep whatever you're feeling inside of you, you are looking for a war. Okay? You're looking for a war. You need to wake, get up out of that shit. All right? All right, Pisces. I don't know what to tell y'all, but to each his own. If you like problems, then go ahead and get the problems. All right? There's so many people out here doing tarots. They can read for your ass. They won't tell you the truth about the shit you in. If you out here trying to please somebody and buy somebody to be with you, go ahead and be their sugar mama. Go right on ahead. If you out here thinking somebody got all this money, you're going to wind up helping them. They ain't going to help your ass. They ain't going to give you a dime, especially if they got fucking kids and a fucking wife or ex-wife. Some of that money definitely going to go to take care of kids. It's like you're looking for bullshit. You know, you need to worry about your kids in your own fucking home. Stop worrying about what the fuck somebody else is doing. You're not their wife. Their wife is going to get whatever they want. Whoever they got kids by, that's what they go. You think you can break up because you want to be in somebody's life. And, oh, you know, well, if you got custody or you, you know, you're going to see your son because the law says you're in the fucking way. You ain't going to break up shit when they go over there and see their kids. They're going to be fucking with that bitch. All right? They're going to always be in somebody's life, especially if they got kids. Why are you stuck on fucking stupid? I'm so sick of this. I'm sick of people messing with other people's man, believing what they saying. The motherfuckers ain't leaving their girl for you. I don't give a fuck who you are. Okay? They're going to always be there. Especially if they got an ex-person they've been with and they love. You think they're going to be with you? No, they're going to fucking be with you for 2 or 3 weeks. And they're going to go back and forth with that person and you. But you fucking can't see it for what it is. And you're going to spend time and years and days is going to turn into weeks. Weeks is going to turn into months. Months is going to turn into years. And guess what? You're stuck in situation you ain't got no business being in because it is there. It is there. Are you fucking listening? It's all in your face. What is wrong with you? All right, let's go. Spirits, tell me what Pisces need to know. Tell me what Pisces need to know. Judgment. Justice, I mean. Justice, Libra. Okay, you want to be fair. You want to be honest. You want to speak the truth. You want to listen to what somebody got to say. You want to balance shit off. All right? You got to hear everything because you got to make a decision here and what it is. You're trying to see things for what it is. All right? You're looking at everything, trying to decide what is the truth and what ain't the truth. All right? Should I let them go or should I sentence them? Come the fuck on. But justice is being served here. Somebody's going to get theirs. All right? The Nine of Swords. Somebody's going through a lot of stress, insomnia, can't sleep, can't think. All right? Somebody is waiting for an outcome from a situation. Somebody is going through it, right? But this right here should make or break you because it's something here that's being completed. And the world don't necessarily mean you got the world in your hand. It means that something is coming to a completion, right? That's what it means. It means that this also can mean that you're coming into everything about you, like you waking up and you saying, okay, so it didn't go my way. Or now I know it's not going my way because I'm stressed out over this. Or you want somebody to change, or somebody's going to court and the outcome, you know, they will have to deal with it is. But it's something telling you, whatever it is that you're judging or being judged, or somebody's not wanting to be with you, you ain't winning on this. Whatever it is that you ain't winning on is bringing you insomnia, anxiety, you can't sleep, you can't think, you can't eat. Everything you're going through, keeping you up at night, always in your head, you know, you need to come to a completion so that you can get everything you want. But it seems like you ain't going to get it if you keep being stuck into this situation that you fucking in, that is not serving you. But for some reason, it's like you want it. It's like you want something that you're not getting, but you're not happy with the outcome that you are now receiving. It's like something here, you're not happy or what you found out. You're not happy or something here with court. It's something here that needs to be balanced. It's something here that maybe you're going to court for or, but it seems like here it's telling you, you know, things will work out. But what are you sentence yourself to? Life with a person that is not worth being with? What are you setting yourself to? Are you going to free yourself? Are you going to come to completion with this 21? What you going to do? Are you gambling yourself like this? Why is you trying to balance things off? either justice, something here is going to be served. And karma will come back and fuck you good. If you fucking with somebody else, man, it's going to fuck with you. If you're doing the wrong things in your life, it's going to come back to you. All right? You ain't going to get away with it. All right? If you starting to see somebody and that person is seeing somebody, or they keep telling you they married but they not living with a person, that's red flags to move the fuck on. Because you got a lot of problems that ain't yours. All right? Justice. Justice will be served. The Ten of Cups. This happy family. All right? So, is it saying that somebody here is still in a court system? Maybe they just get out of jail. Maybe they still involved in court system about a family. About if they got kids with somebody that this person look like they happy with. Maybe this person's taking somebody to court that they had a family with, kids involved. The four swords, they sitting there thinking, but they got the swords under there just in case they got to get it to cut something. All right? The nine of swords. And then you got the four swords. So, yeah, somebody can't sleep and think, but now they're in prayer mode. It's like they're taking a break from a situation here. They praying on it. All right? They in the church. They praying that this work out. It's like somebody's praying to either have a family with somebody. Somebody wants or to something work out from the courts or with their kids, with a person, something here they want. It's like somebody wants something so bad with a person. But it's like they're in prayer mode, right? And I see good things, but it's a lot of Trump oil fighting here with a situation that is probably not even yours, right? This person has a lot to work out before they can be with anybody else, all right? This person's probably married or with somebody or have kids with somebody, all right? This person may have, like I said, I don't know, somebody looking for happiness, but somebody here belonging to somebody else is seeing someone else. Somebody feel like they being left out in the cold, all right? Somebody's bored because they're not getting their way. Somebody's bored because they want something they ain't going to have, or they bored because things ain't going accordingly to what they want, all right? But all the cups are standing up. They just bored. But they're not even realizing that you got everything you want. But why you not looking at it? Because you're too busy looking at shit that is not for you. All right? You sitting there wishing once upon a star, oh, can it please, genie? Can you make this happen for me? But I want this. I don't want that. You're not happy with everything you got. And you need to be happy with everything you got. All right? And stop trying to want more. You're not seeing the whole picture here. You're not seeing everything that's yours already. It's like you bored because somebody here is feeling left out in the cold. All right? They got everything they want, right? But they still not happy. All right? They still not happy. I feel like somebody here can be having a family, the kids and everything, but they sitting here anticipating what's next, praying to God to get them out of a situation they in. Because somebody here is feeling left out in the cold. Maybe this person's involved, got a family. Maybe this person is thinking about what next for them to do. But somebody here is feeling left out in the cold. But they got everything that they should be happy for. But they not happy with what they got. Because what it's like you want something that is not yours. You want something that is not going to make you happy. But you, no matter what, that's what you want. That's what you want. You don't want to see it no other way. Because you want that. It's like you got your mind set up on what you want. That's probably somebody else's. It's not for you. All right? and somebody now is feeling left out in the cold. Or maybe this person wants you, but they feeling left out in the cold because it seems like you was the one that was holding everything up with this person. All right? This person is, and then not only that, but then you feel like you got it all, right? But you don't even see all the blessings you got because your mind is set up on one thing, and that's getting what you want. And I'm going to tell you something. Keep on thinking about getting what you want because you're going to continue being hurt and being used and abused. Somebody here is the sugar mama. Somebody here is wanting somebody, but they're the ones that are taking care of somebody, right? It's like you're their mom, you the fuck, the one they're going to fuck. You the one that's going to take care of them. And it's a lot of bullshit. A lot of bullshit. Tell me more about this Ten of Cups. This is the happy family, but you ain't part of the happy family. Or somebody ain't. The Queen of Wands. Somebody's sexy, nurturing, right? But this Queen of Wands can also mean she can also be like very sluttery, like to, you know, men like her. She likes to dress like she can grab somebody's attention. But this person can be very alive when it comes to the way that they are. They one of the most sexiest queens in a deck of cards, all right? And I mean sexiest, like they can have anybody they want, all right? Somebody looking at you like you the shit. But again, it's a lot of backstabbing. A lot of backstabbing in this situation here. A lot of backstabbing, all right? A lot of backstabbing. You probably feel like somebody backstabbed your ass. All right, this person may be younger than you. This person may feel like they don't want you to expand. They don't want you to grow. All right? Or they think younger than you. They probably sit there and look at your pictures, look at your videos, social media. But this person look at you like you the shit, but they also feel like you leaving them for dead. You leaving them out in the cold. You don't want them. But it's because when you with this person, you can't expand. This person may think younger than you, or it's like y'all looking at each other, but can you move out of this cup and expand? You can't live in a little ass cup, okay? It's like you need to jump out of that cup into the ocean or river, whatever, so that you can be free to expand, to grow. But for some reason, it's like you like something that it's like a taste that you can't get rid of, that you want more of. But is it worth being with somebody that stabbed you in your back, that left you for dead, that's lying, cheating, using, misleading you, all right? It's like you need to make a decision here on what do you want, all right? A decision on what you want, all right? I don't know what to tell you. Right, this is somebody that's got a lot of shit going on. I mean, I feel like I've been doing this reading for a week. It's like got a lot of shit going on in their lives. All right, let go of control issue, allow the situation to unfold naturally. Now, look at this wedding. This situation involves marriage. Look at this, it came out just like this. So, maybe this person's married, maybe they are in a commitment, but you need to stop trying to control a situation. It's like you want to control somebody. You can sit there and turn blue in your face. You ain't going to control nobody. Either you're going to be part of it, become a third wheel, or shut the fuck up and get out of Dodge. What the fuck you going to do? You can talk till you turn blue in the face. The motherfucker's married, he's married. What you going to do? You can't control them. Trust, the situation is calling for you to have faith. But look how this person is trying to move the angel from guiding you. All right, this is a man that it's like you begging them, but don't leave me. And they got a wife. A wife will kiss. But I want you. And the angels are telling you, leave this motherfucker alone. But you're like, no, I want him. What the fuck is wrong with you? You're like a fucking nuisance. You're crazy. I don't want to be with nobody that's like that. All right? Honeymoon. Enjoy the blossom of the holidays. Time together. Maybe you spent time with this motherfucker. Maybe this is the kind of motherfucker that wants to take you on a trip. And that's what they do. That what they do is they do things that you like. So then when it's time for them to go back to wife, they got you all fucked up in your head. And you willing to do anything to be with this person. This person ain't never going to leave their wife. They ain't going to get a divorce. You're stuck in a situation that you shouldn't be in because you fucking stupid. What's wrong with you? What is wrong with you? Oh, but you're married. But you're getting a divorce. But are you going to get a divorce? But I don't understand why you can't get a divorce. I don't understand why you with her. You know, you got your kids and you got custody, you know, y'all share custody with your kids. But why is she in the picture? Because the fuck, she's his wife. That's why she's in the picture. And she's the mother of his kids and she ain't going to never leave. The fuck is wrong with you? Just because you don't have a relationship with your kid's father, just because your kid's father is not part of their life, just because you mom and dad to your kids, don't mean everybody is like you. Okay, I wasn't with my son's father since my son was a baby. But my son's father always had a relationship with his son because he always seen him at his mother's fucking house. Not with me. I'm a fucking Pisces. That's why you a Pisces, because you was fucking born to put up with bullshit. And it seemed like you don't know what bullshit is. Even if it was under your damn nose, you can't even smell shit if it was under your fucking nose, because you addicted to shit. Damn. You can't make somebody what he's married and he got the, I don't give a fuck. What's wrong with you? You're not breaking nobody up. Some people baby, please, I ain't gonna waste my time doing this reading trying to get to somebody that's sitting there looking fucking stupid. Alright? You driving in the car with this nigga. He got kids. All of these women, he probably got kids by a couple women. Okay? You lucky if you got somebody that got kids by one. Because these people got kids by a lot of different people. Alright? And you putting up with that bullshit. You crazy out your ass. You ain't nobody but a piece of pussy. Do you know? You're nothing but pussy to them. And they're going to use you. You ain't going to change your body. Who the fuck are you? Change your damn self. Look at you. You chasing fucking dick and money. That's all you fucking about. Get your own shit. I don't give a fuck if you got your own job. You still living in this fucking world that you are addicted to. Okay? Just because you stop getting high, just because you stop fucking around, doesn't mean that you ain't got an addiction. You got a fucking addiction. All right? Get to know who you are. So when you get to know who you are, maybe you meet the right fucking person. You sizing people by what they look and that's what you like. And inside they rotten as fuck. You don't know, huh? Everything looks good in the outside, but in the inside, they ain't worth shit. Oh, because you see money and beauty in them. That's what you see. You see the devil in a person, the outside. But you don't know shit about that person inside. And you try to read a motherfucker. You read them. So now what you going to do? What you going to do? Nothing. Girl, please. You got a house here. Castle, because that's how you see people. You size them. You see what's the outside. You don't know shit about the inside. Great fortune. Get your own. Move on. You got everything going on for yourself. Why are you trying to get somebody to see things your way? Ain't nobody got to see things your way. All right? Look at this. You sitting there waiting. Waiting. Waiting for what? For somebody to leave their nets and come to you. Wait for the sun to come up. It's crazy. It's like you need to wake up, baby, because something's wrong here. Something ain't right, and it's sad but true. You know, you can try to change a person all you want, but you will never change that person. You will become that person, okay? Because either you're going to leave it or you're going to become it. And if you become it, you ain't looking but not for hell in your life. And if you leave it, then you set yourself free. It's either or. It ain't no both. Okay, what you gonna do? Because guess what? You're living in a delusional world that you want it to be the perfect world, but it's not. You can't live in the delusional world when it's not right anyway. Okay, you're living in this delusional world because you want it to be what you want it to be. You're not seeing it for what it is. If you need to read it, get it from me or someone else. I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.